School of Public Policy, National University of Singapore, to deliver and to share with you the insights and the expertise that, you know, from based on the researches that we have done for the two country studies that he will be presenting this morning, Vietnam and Myanmar. Let's give him a big round of applause. Thank you.
Good morning.
Morning.
My name is Bumi Khum, and I have been with Lee Kwan Yew School of Public Policy for more than 10 years. And one of the main research interests of me, actually is ICT and its impact on economic development. And actually, there's some personal reason for this motivation. You know, I ran a company before, long time before, in 1990. And at that time, you know, have no idea about ICT thing. So, you know, the biggest thing we have actually a fixed phone line. And very costly to make a decision, you know, without information. So, for example, I would like to purchase equipment from Germany to operate the factory. You're waiting for 6 months to get catalogs and no discussion, and, you know, take a lot of time. Just to get some more details, so a couple of years to make a decision. So very costly, you can see. That's the first reason. The second reason, actually, so after I turned around the company very successfully, I got a Fulbright scholarship to go to Harvard Business School for MBA. And, you know, I would like to talk to my wife, and after 3 months, for example, and it cost me $100, and I had to make an appointment, send a letter to her first to say, okay, 7 p.m. on Saturday, you know, on Thursday, and get her actually agreement. And she had to wait in the post office, you know, waiting for my call from the U.S., you know, long time, unbelievable. And, you know, that's so memorable. Now, actually, we are so, happy to live in very exciting time. So in the past 30 years, we have witnessed so much, you know, changes, amazing experience. And I must say, Li Peng actually just emphasize again, we do not know even, you know, what would happen in the next 30 years. Must be very exciting. And three things here, I have witnessed. The first thing is dream coming true. That's actually a series of dreams come true. In 1980, you know, everyone just dreamed to have a personal computer on the desktop of some family, of some, you know, office, and Microsoft helped that happen. In 1990s, people dreamed to have, you know, access to the human knowledge, you know, learning about internet, that happened. And in 2010, people want to have a social network, now Facebook have that one. And the exciting thing is this, actually now, not only in the US or Europe, but the Philippines, Vietnam, we are on par with them, you know, on Facebook, whatever. So the same thing, that's amazing. And here, that's the first thing, dream come true. The second thing is transformation. So I see huge change everywhere. In Vietnam, the Philippines, you see the same thing, the hotel, SME, same attitude, the same way of doing business, very similar. And the first one I come up with is the ketchup thing. Ketchup actually exciting thing. In your life, you feel must actually very great actually and see huge ketchup. And here, Vietnam, Philippines, and actually Vietnam and Myanmar, the two cases I presented today actually show you some unbelievable story, you know, about catching up. For the Philippines, I also see huge catching up because in my study, you can see it's good for policymaker always to do the review what we have caught up and what we fall behind. And for Philippines, here's something I see the catch up thing, actually the outsourcing the Philippines actually caught up and surpassed India. That's amazing. And the determinants of catching up actually are three things. The first one, we have to understand your strength. That's very important thing. So Philippines, you know, fluent in English, you know, 12-hour time zone different from the US. That's the big advantage for the Philippines. The second thing, seizing technology. So technology help you make huge leapfrog. But the third one, very important, we have to identify, excellent partner. So the here in this conference, you can see great two partner, LKY School and Microsoft should be great partner for you to leapfrog, to catch up. And in Vietnam, I have many business friends. They ask me, can you consult with them, invite some Filipino, you really want to develop, some very nice place, inviting 10,000 Filipino here to build some con center so that you can create a job for 50 other Vietnamese, for example. And, Vietnam, Philippines, they work together to become the con center, because very similar. You can see that one, and I hope, we can make that happen. So now I focus on such the cases of Vietnam and Myanmar in our catching up. And for Vietnam, because I study the policy and working closely with the government, and here comes Mr. Tien here also and can support me and can give me some more insight. But here, starting, we want to have catching up. First one, have to have an aspiration. And Vietnam declared very clearly, Vietnam will be very strong with ICT. And we'll be strong by ICT. So with ICT, we have to be in the forefront. And by ICT, we'll be strong, driven by ICT. That's the key thing. And Prime Minister, leader, all agree with that. No question about that. Now just need initiative, right? And coordination. That's the key thing. So very, very first thing, have to have that aim. And you can see that happen. So now I will show you, actually I have this one. In my, because I have high for two cases, so I think I enjoy it for details. So in my presentation, I give you a very brief introduction and give you some information on cloud computing adoption in Vietnam and Myanmar, and share with you some insight from my survey. The survey supported by Microsoft and LKY. So the actually what the government should do to promote cloud computing in Vietnam in developing countries. So here, if you look at this picture, we can see two dimensions here. One, actually, internet penetration and the Facebook penetration. Of course, for the country like China or South Korea or Japan, they have their own version of Facebook, for example. So we're not sure about the penetration of the social media. However, for other countries, we don't have our own social media version. So we rely on Facebook to see how much actually advanced in this front. And you can see Vietnam keep moving up, on internet penetration and Facebook. And the people in Vietnam, from the kids to my father, for example, is 90 years old, enjoying this, I think Vietnam and the Philippines share similar, characteristics because they have a lot of people living overseas. So somehow Facebook, internet is a big gift, of the technology to our nation. So now we have, constant communication, sharing a lot of things. So we can see here. And Vietnam is far ahead most countries and just a little bit behind most advanced nations on this penetration. And here we live in actually the fourth industrial revolution. And if you want to take away or remember about the fourth industrial revolution, you have to know three characteristics. And all of these actually supported and by cloud computing. The first one is a platform. So the company, customer, partner actually are in the ecosystem, have to coordinate, coordinate with each other very closely on in a real-time basis. And they have a platform exists, co-innovates. So that's the very first thing. The second one actually use a smart technology to improve efficiency, production, virtual reality, 3D printing, all of these things. And the third one is decision making, the green time, and big data help you to make better decisions. And all of this, actually for all of this, cloud computing is so critical. Without cloud computing, no way. Especially for the company, the small and medium-sized company, or the government, no way. So cloud computing is actually together. And here is actually my discussion in Vietnam. So we should take the offense or defense attitude. It means we should be proactive to see ICT, cloud computing as a way for us to advance ahead, or we just, you know, passively take it so that we do not fall behind. And I'm sure that for catching up nation like the Philippines and Vietnam, take an offense approach very important. Proactive in this thing. See, you know, taking this actually our the powerful weapon, a driver to catch up. So cloud computing adoption in Vietnam and Myanmar. So the good news here is that when we look at the data on cloud computing spending per capita, for example, you can see growth, you know, unbelievable. The growth rate, you know, 50-60% per year. It's like, you know, double, you know, every 18 months, less than 2 years. And Vietnam and the Philippines actually on the top. That's exciting. However, per capita, you know, cloud computing. In the future, you know, it cannot just rely on GDP per capita, but also cloud computing per capita, you know, information, transmission per capita, something like that. Basically, that somehow characterizes the development of a nation. And you can see here, per capita, Vietnam spent about $1.7 per year in 2016. The Philippines a little bit ahead, $2.2. And compared to Indonesia, it matter. You know, Indonesia just 1.2. But things changing. But I see the very fast growth for Vietnam and the Philippines. But you know, it's far below advanced nation, and especially the actually Singapore nearly 100 times higher than Vietnam. So a long way to go. But the very interesting for ASEAN country is that we have a last breakthrough, you know, from laggards like Myanmar to the pioneer like Singapore. So it means this variation can help all the nation, the 10 nations in ASEAN learn from each other a lot and motivating other, inspiring each other to learn. So you can see the distribution of ASEAN countries can shift very fast forward in the time to come. For the Myanmar, you can see they actually really a leapfrog nation on ICT in recently. For example, on mobile phone, you know, in 2010, nothing. 2010, you know, and after that, now 75, you know, or subscriber per 100 people. So, and most people use a smartphone now. You can see a lot, amazing thing, you know. However, still lacking behind one more sophisticated ICT access like a broadband. So still very, very negligible, very small. So that's a challenge for cloud computing. So basic infrastructure actually still lacking, but they work on that. And for ICT, the use, I can see actually for Myanmar, it's way below the 3.5 level. It means the average one, the four actually is average, global average. So Vietnam, Philippines, somehow Philippines just a bit about, you know, the red one is the government and the blue one actually the business. So the Philippines actually somehow at the average level, Vietnam a little bit behind, and Myanmar is very low, the laggard in ASEAN, among ASEAN, but also compared to many other nations. That's a big challenge. Implication that cloud computing is, you know, not much available in Myanmar. In Vietnam, I can give you the survey. A lot of people know about cloud computing already. But in Myanmar, you know, they use it, but they may not understand it yet. And if you ask 10 government officials about cloud computing, 9 people have no idea about what cloud computing is. So awareness is a big problem before we're talking about coordinating, you know, the initiative to promote cloud computing. Now, I share with you the survey that with the support of Microsoft and our school, we conduct a survey. So 364 BCC's executive and around 100 government officials. So because you want to promote cloud computing adoption, we have to understand how they perceive about the benefits from cloud computing. Very important thing. Because in theory, we know a lot, but how about the actual people, you know, in their work, how they see that one, and what's actually the obstacle facing their adoption. And if they can advise the Prime Minister, the government, they think what should be the priority. And I see quite an encouraging and positive result, very good insight. So, of course, you know, this sample not representative of the companies, because we have to choose the company who have certain level of sophisticated knowledge of cloud computing, and that's what actually cloud computing is. So it means somehow just top 20%, like expert level, not and also just based in Hanoi and Ho Chi Minh City. So for the companies here, you can see the small one and big one and medium one. And here's quite interesting insight. We talk to the young people, small firm, they say, why we have to use a cloud computing anyway? Because we cannot afford to buy our own server, you know, and cloud computing, you don't have to, you know, to hire a big team of IT. So now just rely on outside provider. Very flexible, very convenient, low cost, and I can have access to the world class computing, comparable to anyone. So young one, small one, startup one, definitely cloud computing is the way to go. The medium one, that problem, that's a legacy problem. Okay, I have some server here already, you know, and I don't really need the new one. It's okay for now. And the biggest one, they have a lot of assets, they say security issue. How about, you know, I have this kind of information, that kind of information. So different concern, different incentive. So that's why the role of government is quite important in pushing for cloud computing adoption. So government here, you can see the local also adopt cloud computing. Central government also adopt one, went higher in central government. So the first here, I asked, okay, what are the benefits? And they rate actually the first one, agility. We can see flexibility, you know, we don't need to make huge investment upfront. Right away, it's like electricity, just hook up the network and you have a computing power. So in the future, we just buy terminal for the employee and have access to the world class, you know, computing power. That's amazing. So everyone agree, that's very clear. You know, if you invest in your own, you have to build your air conditioning room and take 6 months and purchasing equipment, whatever. Here, just the services. But Mr. Tien, later on, I can share with us, you know, in Vietnam, have to change some regulation because in Vietnam, purchasing the power computing services, it still have to consider as investment, not services. You cannot purchase on a year basis. You have to think about like the long-term investment. So that's a regulatory challenge. The second one, we can better accommodate the rapid growth. Because today, we just have this month, but tomorrow, 2 years from now, if expanding, you can buy more. So if we cannot keep expanding your rule, you know, infrastructure for your own. Technology changing, your company size changing. So definitely we have to rely on the cloud computing. And the third one, definitely because of this one, we have powerful, you know, cloud computing, power. So it become a lot more competitive. And also make more profit, that the company confirm. And you can see their rating from 1 to 5, so nearly the 4.0 level. In Vietnam, that's very strong. So similarly, we can buy it from government, share the same thing, and improving the performance, they see for sure. Because if you use own your server, a lot of problem, and relying on your own IT team and a lot of uncertainty. Asking about the obstacles, they see her here problem. I am not sure about the Philippines. In Vietnam, they say the software privacy, because if you own by your own server computer, you can get around with the software property right. But cloud computing, we have to pay for that. Not a concern. The second one is quite important. That's And this one actually even more severe in Myanmar. Lack of knowledge about the benefit from cloud computing adoption. Everyone say it's good, but not convincing evidence yet. So that's why. So I can show you. It's quite interesting. The green one and the blue one. So the people who have adopted cloud computing have a higher confidence. And confirmation that the benefit is good, and also they send the obstacle is higher for them. If they understand this thing, they can do much better. So the first one is security concern. So you can see the adopter actually most sophisticated on this one, and they confirm this thing. So that's why government have to address this issue effectively. So government actually share similar thing. Now, so what actually government should do to promote cloud computing adoption? In the past, for the traditional technology, we mostly focus on regulating. But for technology, emerging technology like this, no way for us actually just to think about regulate, think about enabling first, For the Uber, to cloud computing, have to enable them first, and also work closely with the business and academics company to figure out how to regulate them to best benefit from technology progress. But the first one have to raise awareness. So like a platform, you think about the Uber, if you have more people participating in this business, the cost will be much lower and people find it a lot more convenient. So critical mass is needed. So raising awareness is a very critical one for all developing countries. Second one, creating enabling condition. So we need broadband infrastructure must be reliable. And services must be very good. And the first one, people want to have incentive. In Ireland, for example, if they are to promote online payment, they say you pay online. In the past, because they have problem with the check, they get you to just write a checkbook, a check. Now they want to promote online payment because online payment can help the country reduce, save at least 1% of GDP rather than just cash in. So here, incentive. Okay, what kind of incentive the government can give business if they adopt cloud computing? That's important thing. So in developing country or even developed country, company actually different a lot of incentive. The first one, that's exciting thing, monitoring. In Vietnam now, I think they work very hard on this effort, monitoring the ICT readiness of provinces, of ministry. So every year they have a report monitoring Vietnam. So Mr. Tien can share with us all that thing. But very helpful, because no one wants to be in the bottom. So 20% of the provinces in the bottom, okay, have to explain why. So at least we can say it's unfair, whatever, but we have to explain. So once they explain it, maybe you have to learn to see what happened. Otherwise, everything is better than before. But better than before, but it's in the bottom of the 63 provinces in Vietnam or ministry. So it's very helpful. So monitoring. And the last one, evaluating and learning. For developing countries, catch-up nation, definitely learning and evaluating the what we are now. Very important. That's why this kind of report, annual or regular periodic report, very important to take stock of what we are now, where we are now. So that's very helpful. So in terms of priority of the business and government agency suggestions, they say definitely the first one, infrastructure. Even we have now somehow very good infrastructure in many ways, in terms of affordability and the broadband. However, you know, still need to upgrade because it totally rely on cloud. It means we have to have, you know, very reliable access to network, otherwise problem. Second one, the interesting here, because we don't have government official here, but always say, you say good, government go first. You know, if government, you know, do not go with ICT, cloud computing, why ask us to do? Of course, you based on profit or incentive, but government go first should have very powerful effect. That's the second one. And the first one, actually, some incentive. We need some incentive. But if, without incentive, but government go first, it's like a drive. Moving toward cloud computing should be very effective, very impactful. The similar perception by government agency, you can see infrastructure, government have to take the leading role, and government also emphasize, especially in provinces, raising the awareness of the benefit of cloud computing. So this kind of conference, quite important for us to raise awareness across community, especially in the local level, not the central capital one. They need to know more about the benefit from ICT adoption. And I would like to share with you my smart model. If you want to, you know, embrace an initiative, make it successful, a remarkable achievement, you should think about smart model. S stand for strategy. Definitely strategy. In Singapore, that's what I really like. Always success of Singapore just calculated in one word, it's a strategy. So Singapore is S stand for strategy. So everything they deal with, they have a strategy. That's important. Strategy means we have to know your strength, your weaknesses, and technology. Opportunity and your partner. Who are your partner? So like here, you can see Microsoft, you know, LKY, definitely reliable partner can work with. That's amazing. Second one, monitoring. You know, whatever we do, we have to monitor. KPI, what are KPI here? How much, you know, spending on cloud computing? What is percentage of SME if you have adopted ICT cloud computing? Something like that. Monitor that one and just, you know, make it transparent and public, very important. First one, accountability. Someone have to be responsible for this one, coordinating that, you know, and promote the other one, come up with incentive. So some agency, government have to have some department, some agency in charge of coordinating the whole process. Otherwise, no one accountable for this one. So we can say very beautiful things, but no one accountable, not good. But the first one, very important, it's rethinking. Many things do not just, you know, follow the old pattern. A lot of things new. So like a cloud computing in the past, you just thought, you know, like a touchin in Thailand, just investing, you know, purchasing more server for each company, so giving the, you know, tax deduction for investing in ICT. Maybe not be good. I give you tax deduction for, you know, cloud computing, not just your own server. In Singapore, you also have problem. You supply your own server. Not good, may not good, you know. Here is, if you spend money on cloud computing, that's good for the whole system and for yours, long term. So incentive must be that way. So rethinking important. And the last one, trust. You know, Vietnam, excellent on many things. However, below many other countries on cloud computing readiness, just because of two things, cyber security and sophistication of business people. So if your app actually presented before, Vietnam lower than the Philippines, not because of connectivity or affordability, but because of two things. The first one, actually, cybersecurity, we are weaker than the Philippines, and sophistication of the business sector. So here, we are actually have to choose between the two. Sleepy, like this man, very happy, say don't know no change, or go with cloud computing, flying horse, you know? That's the perfect choice, you know? So I hope you can see something from Vietnam. I'll catch you up, you know, motivation and the cloud actually open the door for. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Ho Ming Kong, to provide his own actual policy-related expertise. Let's call on Mr. Nguyen Phu Thien from